Immunizations are the most significant public health intervention available, so it's important that they are effective to keep our communities safe and protected. Proper storage and handling of vaccine is important. Vaccines are made of sensitive biological substances that can lose their potency. Only publicly funded vaccines should be kept in the vaccine fridge. Medical specimens, food, drinks, and private medications should not be kept in the same fridge. If you can't store private medications separately, they should be marked and kept on a different shelf. All publicly funded vaccines should be stored in the middle shelf of a fridge because there's better airflow and the temperature is more stable. Vaccines should not be stored in the door of a fridge because temperatures constantly change from the door being opened and closed. Touch the walls of a fridge because they are much colder and can damage the vaccine. Store it on the bottom shelf or in a vegetable crisper because there is poor airflow. Ensure proper spacing between vaccines for proper airflow and to keep the temperature stable. If a multi-dose vial is punctured, make sure it's labeled with the date and time of puncture. Multi-dose vials expire after puncture, and the manufacturer's packaging will show the expiry date. Some are 28 days and some are 30 days. It varies depending on the manufacturer and the type of vaccine. All publicly funded vaccines should be kept in the original packaging. Some vaccines are light sensitive and can be damaged. Vaccines should be organized in order of expiry, as well as vaccine type. There should only be a month's supply of vaccine. This decreases the chance of unused vaccine expiring and wastage. If the fridge has a built-in freezer, it should be defrosted regularly with less than 1 centimeter thick of ice. The vaccine should be removed and put into a monitored cooler or another monitored vaccine fridge. Ensure the fridge is not on an external wall or in direct sunlight. External walls and direct sunlight can affect the temperature of the fridge and may cause fluctuations. Ensure the outlet for the fridge is protected to prevent accidental unplugging. Place a Do Not Unplug sticker by the outlet or ensure the outlet is not easily accessible. The size of the fridge should accommodate the amount of vaccine that has been ordered and should be in a well-ventilated area. Vaccine fridges should be kept away from public access. There can be a lock on the vaccine fridge door or kept in a locked room, like a nursing office. When checking the temperatures for the vaccine fridge, it is important to know how the thermometer works, how to check the maximum, minimum, and current temperatures, and how to reset the maximum, minimum temperatures. When documenting temperatures in the logbook, it's important to write the date and time the temperature was taken. If there is a temperature excursion, the times are used as a reference point to determine the vaccine viability. Once temperatures have been documented, the thermometer needs to be reset for the next check. This makes the tracking of temperatures more accurate. Having the probe in the middle shelf in the middle of the fridge is important, because the most stable temperatures are in the middle of the fridge due to airflow. If your temperatures are fluctuating, line the fridge with cold, unopened water bottles in the door and on the bottom of the fridge. The cold water bottles act as insulation to keep temperatures more stable. If temperatures are still not stable, the fridge may need to be adjusted. Store the vaccine in a stable place and monitored until the fridge is stabilized. Temperatures out of range below plus 2 degrees Celsius or above plus 8 degrees Celsius must be reported to the health unit right away. When reporting temperatures, time of excursion and length of excursion is important to determine vaccine viability. The person who checks and records the fridge temperatures and their backup person should be aware of the cold chain reporting process. A vaccine inventory form will need to be filled out and faxed or emailed to the health unit. The health unit will send the facility this form. Do not use any of the publicly funded vaccines until the health unit nurse checks the vaccine viability with manufacturers. Bag the vaccine in a brown paper bag and label "Do not use." Store in working monitored fridge until it's confirmed by a health unit nurse that the vaccine is viable. If vaccine is viable, a red dot is placed on the vaccine to be used first. If vaccine is not viable, it must be bagged, labeled with your facility's name and date, and returned to the health unit. Vaccine storage and handling is important. By following the proper steps to maintain fridge temperatures, keeping vaccine stock in the right places, and maintaining the cold chain, you can ensure that vaccine is at its most effective to protect our population and our loved ones.